Hi everyone, my name is Yurami, and I'm a program manager in Azure Active Directory. Today I'm here to talk about a strategy around forming your cloud-first infrastructure. I'm sure many of you have already seen this slide and the concept of identity as the control plane in a cloud-first world. In the complex world we live today, you need Azure Active Directory to anchor and build the foundation of your cloud-first infrastructure. But we're finding most organizations don't understand what that means. And so this conversation is about building that strategy. What are the controls in a cloud-first world? Your control is about those users and not the old world of the network. It's about knowing and understanding what you can control, what you should control, and what's the best way to control those. And that's around everything that user touches from their device, the applications, and ultimately to protect that small percentage of data that lives in your organization. So what is a must? What is a should have? And where should you build the best world? You know, this is all dependent on the maturity of your infrastructure, your IT infrastructure, and especially that's one that's based on a cloud-first model. So let's talk about that. We know in order to control your users, you have to understand the user base. And most organizations have three types of users, and you want to set up a level of protection for those users. Identity in the cloud and in a cloud-first world, there's many different function of scenarios that are cloud-based and that the old world of Active Directory does not control. There's the core identity access management that still applies, but there's much more. You can now control users outside the company you work with, whether they're partners or your customers. You can set up a lot of self-service, auto type of technology for your user base to control. There's, at the end of the day, security and protection has to happen at minimum for most organizations. And again, it starts with identity. Governance and compliance are ones you can't get away from. They're required as part of your industry or your company, so that's IT has to help meet that. Most customers are making decisions on technology based on how they will live and breathe that in production. And application management, whether it's your own applications, Microsoft's applications, or some other third-party application, you want to have controls around those and how you're accessing. And the type of reporting you can get today with Azure Active Directory, real-time, is so robust and very mature, and that's all the things that Azure Active Directory can provide. So what does that mean? Again, back to what's a must, what do I need to do at minimum, and what's the best world? Well, we've broken the infrastructure framework into three tiers. There's some things you have to do at the baseline level, at a foundational level, just like having all your users, all your applications, the devices that they touch in Azure Active Directory. If you don't have that, you can't manage production and take advantage of the Azure Active Directory capabilities that we built for monitoring, reporting, system health, security health. That's the minimum, that second layer, just managing, you know, old production, automating, building more and more capabilities that the world has promised that when you go into production. But again, to build efficiencies, to save a company time and money, it's getting to that automated layer, and that's the third layer. That's where we want to help you get to. You can bake in governance, you can make audits much easier and be compliant at that third layer. And there's many different features and capabilities in Azure Active Directory that has that. So let's take a little look further. So your best world is that third layer. But at the bottom layer, there are things you must do today in order to go to the next two layers. There's over 20 different features today in Azure Active Directory. And our engineering team is coming up with more solutions, building more features, and this will grow. And you receive all this with our premium capabilities, our highest level SKU. So what does that mean? You know, in the world of Active Directory, if it was much easier, but in the cloud identity layer, how should, in those identity scenarios, how is that enabled? And what do I look at the three tiers? This is just an example of those Azure AD premium features, what they look like in this three-tier framework. So as you approach your technology projects, whether you're upgrading your office and your productivity suite, or you're transitioning from Skype to Teams to build collaboration, or just managing an application and upgrading Windows, you want to look at these three tiers and build, make sure you enable the bottom layer for identity to put those controls in place before you even deploy the other workloads to enable your workbase. And if you need help, there's a lot to do. If you need help, Microsoft has included a program called Fast Track, which is just some services included with your license to help you learn about the product, help you deploy and use the product. It's a starting line. We know most of your workbase, they need knowledge, they need to learn, they need help, you know, guidance to deploy, and even when things are in production, how to drive adoption and build that end-user support. So that's just part of some of the services that Fast Track does. But Fast Track is just one level of service. The engagement model to take one technology into production involves many different people and many different resources. And it starts with your team. Fast Track can help start. But the engagement model is very complementary, whether you're using Microsoft services or a partner. So if you want Fast Track's help, please visit the link below and put in a request for assistance. Thank you for watching this video. And good luck with your deployment.